One of the key features of NeoLoad Web is to publicize results in real time to a website for external stakeholders to review. These could be DBAs or development teams. Another feature of NeoLoad Web is the ability to run tests via the web browser on available infrastructure. These could be controllers or load generators on the network that you simply select at runtime. The final choice with NeoLoad Web is whether you decide to use a SaaS subscription model or whether you decide to have an on-premise instance. In order to integrate NeoLoad and NeoLoad Web, the first thing you require is an authorization token. We can get this from a SaaS instance. We can also get it from the on-premise installation. One thing to be aware of, if you're using the NeoLoad free license, you're automatically entitled to use NeoLoad Web on SaaS. Simply use the login details that you used to log into our website with. In this example here, we've gone to the profile tab and we've copied our authorization token. We're going to do the same behavior, but this time using the on-premise version. So we select our profile tab. And again, we copy the authorization token. In this example, though, we're going to place this token inside NeoLoad. So we open up NeoLoad, we go to the Edit menu, and we select Preferences. On the Preferences screen, we select NeoLoad Web. And as you can see here, there's two deployment options. One is a SaaS instance, one is the on-premise. If I was using SaaS, I would just paste in my token. In our example, though, we're going to be using the on-premise one. We've tested our connection. One thing to mention at the bottom here is we've got our subscription value. The subscription on the SaaS model is how much of allowance we've got remaining. We select on-premise. We paste in our URL. Again, we would paste in our token. And we test our connection. Unlike the SaaS model, because it's an on-premise installation, there is no subscription allowance. We activate the integration. And finally, we click OK. With the integration now complete, when we run our test in NeoLoad, we can push results into NeoLoad Web. Let's rename the description here. Once we've given it a meaningful name, ensure that you transfer to NeoLoad Web checkbox is checked, and then we can click play. The test is now initializing, it's now beginning to kick off. In the status bar here, we can see the updates. So initializing, sending data to NeoLoad Web, and now we have a running test. If we go back to NeoLoad Web, go back to the home screen, you can see here is our running test. If we select the link, these are the live metrics coming from NeoLoad being published on the NeoLoad Web website.